Hi, in this video I'll show you how to integrate Notion with Deepnote. I showed you around Deepnote in the previous video. Now, Notion is a note-taking app. It does have both a desktop app version and also a web app version which you can access from your browser. So here I have accessed Deepnote from my browser after having created an account in Notion, and it's free, and this is a note. So in a note, you can have different elements such as text, pictures, and you can also embed videos. This is a video from YouTube embedded in here. And you can also embed Deepnote code cells in Notion. And then you can share your Notion note to turn it into a web page. So if you go to the share button, you just make sure that is switched on, and then you copy that link, and now that link everyone can use it. So let's see from a private web browser session what we get. Yeah, so that's the web page. You can share information with anyone using Notion. So we haven't added any Deepnote cells just yet, so let's do that. So you can add blocks in Notion. You can add text, as I did. More info here. So as I did in these other cells. So everywhere you click, you can add a cell. By pressing slash, you have the options what you can add. So for example, I can type in image and image will show up, and you can click that and you can upload an image. Similar for video. So you can click on video and so on. Now, how do we embed Deepnote cells? Well, you have to go to Deepnote, open the notebook, the Deepnote notebook you want to get a cell from. And for example, let's get this print main. If you click there, on the right here, you see the share block button. You click that, and this is the dialog window. So you want to click that to switch that on. And what do you want to do? Do you want to share the code or just the output? So you see the preview here, how it will look like. So if we say just the output, then all you have to do is just copy this link here. You don't need this embed block, just this share block. So copy and then go to Notion and just paste it there in a cell, in a Notion cell. And Notion should ask you to create an embed. So press on create embed. And there we see the output of that cell. So then again, always remember you can share these. So copy that and everyone can access that URL. So there we go. That's the value. Now see what happens if this output in the cell in the notebook is updated. So I'll run this again after having run all the notebook, of course, or you can just click on run notebook. So to run one cell, you should run the previous cells first. You know that all, or just click run notebook as I just did. So now we have 22 here. But did the Notion web page also update to reflect the change in this value? Well, let's check that. Now, it doesn't happen automatically, so it's supposed that the user will refresh the page. And then if you go down here, you'll see the fresh, the new value, 22. So whenever the visitors are visiting your web page, your Notion web page, they will see the most updated Deepnote output or code cells or code if you include the code in the embed. So that allows you to do cool things like generating different outputs with Python, maybe processing CSV files which are updated somewhere else, and you show the output, the average, for example, of a particular column in a Deepnote here. And you keep this Deepnote running with a while loop, maybe, and so you can then have that output updated in the Notion web page as well. So it's a very keen way to distribute a program to show the results. And that's about this video. So thank you for following. Let's do some more videos. See you.